Seen her 55? But yeah, I saw.
And action.
Stop her!
You run through the dark. A maze of passages. You see a light through the door.
A visitor? It's been so long since my angel and I had company.
There's no escape.
You struggle. Antonia screams.
I go to my God. It will be a mercy to escape this world.
Stay dead.
Okay, now it kind of makes more sense, I guess.
I have some business to attend to before this.
53 Charlie, take two.
The feast day should mark an end to this string of misfortune. And I am eager to hear your sermon.
St. Clair is close to my heart.
The prioress also wants to use this evening to put behind her the awful business with the girl. I forget her name.
Agnes.
Yes, Agnes. Well, I believe the return to health of yourself and young Rosario is enough to give thanks for.
If I may excuse myself, I have some business to attend to before the celebrations. I will return in time.
What is so urgent on feast day?
I promised the late Antonia that I would pray by her body on this day to secure the passage of mother's soul to her side. She was worried that her mother died without absolution.
A deathbed promise. Well, you cannot break that.
Later, Father.
Cat. Maybe start eating the orange earlier.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the scene before going down to rape her. I don't think there's anything else to say about this. Seems pretty uneventful. Wait. He's in this movie as well?
Scene 8A, take two.
Settle down. Action.
We found plaster and some cloth fibers.
Someone made a mask of his face.
Before or after death?
Before.
They usually have a tube. We figure he let himself be cast, but the killer cut off the air supply. The penis was cut off post-mortem, though the condition of the corpus cavernosum and the amount of blood does suggest it was a wreck when this happened, so probably soon after death.
Jesus. When does a crime scene begin?
A crime scene begins at the point where the suspect changes intent into action.
And who had the intent?
Mentioned there about our muse?
Well, nothing incriminating. Some of it's in code, though.
Might just be doodles.
Always has his head in a book, missing what's right in front of his eyes.
I think he really thinks she didn't do it.
I think he wants to fuck her.
I don't think Goodman fucks.
Cut!
He's alive!
Wait, this isn't John Durick. Who's playing the corpse? Also, yeah, I should say, again, nothing serious here, other than the fact that this guy played in both movies. Maybe John Durick brought him along. Maybe it's like a troupe. These things happen, I think, with castings. Like, sometimes, you know, people bring their friends or people who have worked together in the past. Stuff like that. Oh, this guy doesn't appear anywhere else.
"56 Charlie, take five."
"All right, Ambrosio, Chrome, God has compelled will walk yourself here in after pleasures of the flesh and action.
God has compelled me to follow in St. Clair's example. I too have shunned society and devoted myself to prayer and to a pure life that brings me closer to God. Clair showed that this devotion has power, that it can manifest in the world. Purity is an act that lifts those around us. We shun the rewards of a corporal life. We shun the cheap pleasures of the flesh. We bask in the love of God. Clair's example compels us to piety. Imagine with me Clair's journey as she escapes her parents' palace. In the dark of night, she creeps through the basement, escaping out the door we call the door of the dead. She is reborn. She ran to a chapel where she cut her hair, shed her expensive clothes, swapping them out for ash cloth.
Donia, may the Virgin. What devilry is at work here?
And cut. Marvelous, Sophia. Mark that spot. Let's set up there for good.
Check the gate.
Oh, she was holding Ambrosio's cross when he stabbed her. So that's incriminating him. That's interesting. That's a cool twist. There was a vibration much earlier. Also, why was no one doing anything? They're just looking at her.
Weddings, funerals, black masses. I've seen a few. It was all not.
That's what she said. That's what the French girl said to her. Is that the scene? But wait, that's Marissa Marcel. Hold on. I want to see that again. Is the woman... That's still Sophia, isn't it? That's not Marissa. Yeah, that's Sophia. But when she drops her... It becomes... Marissa. Interesting. What? Okay, hold on. So that wasn't a real person? Is that what it's trying to say? It was a puppet?
Scene 11, Alpha, take 3.
Action.
Raphael, what the fuck with this suit?
I told you that hair and makeup would be less grueling for the shoot.
No photos of me in this thing, ever. Okay, close set, no cameras.
You look great.
It's not about how I look, it's how I feel. Plus, I thought the whole thing with the computers was that it doesn't matter who's in the suit. Anyone can have my body.
Well, no one moves the way you do, Maria.
You are one in a million.
Gary.
That's my favorite client.
Hungover. I look like a mime fell in a ball pit.
brought you coffee, but they said no liquids in the volume.
Shall we begin?
Please.
Okay. T-pose? Like this? Cue the music. That right there, that's you. Nobody can copy that. Cut away all this. And inside your core being is what we are capturing. The real Maria.
Cut. All right, going again. Peter, once she's in, keep your eyes on Maria, even when you're walking away.
You want me to talk while walking backwards?
That's funny. First of all, the animation that we saw here on the projection, that was not the same thing that Marissa was supposedly doing. That was not the same motion capture. Definitely not. Also, it's kind of funny how the camera kept moving around again while she was dancing, because she's not a dancer, so the camera has to hide that. I'm not mocking her. I just think it's a funny trick. Anyways, other than that, Maria's reaction to the mocap suit was kind of funny, and I think I saw a vibration while she was dancing. There it was.
The two of us, we should have known better. The two of us could be so much better. The two of us, we should have known better. The two of us. So much better. You and me, everything comes in pairs. Me and you, you and me, got two of everything. Two hands, two eyes, got two of everything. Too much of everything. You and me, forevermore, baby. Scares me, can we just be you and me?
Okay, that was just a dancing choreography, nothing much to say other than there was another. Oh, the vibration is to just take us back to the other thing. Okay. So there's nothing else here. I don't understand why there's three of them while the song is called Two of Everything. Is it to imply that there's more than two? There's three of them. Because who were all those people waking up when Marissa died? That was weird. So, yeah, I don't understand. Also, there's the other people. There's the other dude, the blonde dude, who became Carl Greenwood.
Let's take a look.
And at some point was actually Marissa, if I'm not mistaken. And also, he was Amy. So, yeah. Very confusing, all of this. Wait, can we see the other dudes again? Nope, they don't appear again. Oh, wait. Yeah. The dude said that's Maria, her core being, and we have isolated it when he was talking about the articulated skeletal animation thing. So that's Maria, so that's Marissa, basically. So he's trying to say that when we click on that thing, we will be taking to Marissa, because that's her true self.
15 apple, take 2.
And action. Matilda? Matilda? Help! Call for the problems! Who's on your fallen? What have you done?
Feel my heart. Kiss me.
Cut. Are you cutting?
Still rolling. Let's get this.
Stop bloody improvising. She doesn't kiss him until scene 16.
It's a martini. Let her have some fun. Sex you're adding on the floor.
Cut.
Okay. They were already taking control of the movie away from him at this point. No, wait. No. Yeah. Because here they were already taking control from him. And this, yeah. So this, the movie had already escaped from him. So this is scene 16. So this is 15. Okay. Also, you know what? What we said earlier about the animation being the core being of Marissa, maybe it's not. Maybe it's the core being of her, not Marissa, because she was the one controlling her while she was dancing.
The Great War
again, god damn it. Okay, let's try to get more Marissa.
I need to pull these off pretty quick.
Yeah, we've seen this.
Forty apple, take 2.
And action.
As a friend, I see that you are upset by something.
There is little that can be done about it.
You are in love. I am not jealous. You are in love with Antonia Dalfa. Tonight you visited her mother and took the chance to speak with her privately. Together you read scripture.
How could she know of this? Has she spoken of it?
You do not know my full history. Before I joined the Order, I was in the care of a guardian. He sought to educate me in all the arts, including those often disdained.
Matilda.
I had no cause to use these skills before, but love compelled me. I could not be with you myself. I still had a need to see you. This device allows me to see where I am not. It shows its holder the object of their affection.
You jest?
No. Think on your love. Think on Antonia.
Droll the Nazis.
And react.
Oh my god.
The same magic that powers this lens can also grant you what you wish.
How so?
You remember the night that I was to die, when we took to St. Clair's sepulcher? That night, I performed a rite. I summoned a fallen angel to aid me.
What have you done?
I admit I trembled before the act, but there was nothing to fear. The rite protected me, and the demon obeyed. I did not sell my soul to a master, but through my courage, purchased a slave. His power has shown you Antonia. You can also put her in your arms.
I will not employ Hell's agency.
Is your mind so feeble it falls to childish prejudices? How is it that I, a woman, have the strength to wield this power, but you do not?
I will not be God's enemy.
And are you his friend now? You have already broken your vows. You are bent on the seduction of an innocent. Do not reject my offer out of false piety, if it is simply cowardice that restricts you.
My cowardice may yet prevent my damnation. I yield. I must have her, whatever the cost.
I will collect my tools and meet you by the crypt. Don't look so nervous.
Cat.
Damn, the actress who plays Marissa Marcel is amazing. Anyway, that was the scene we saw in the TV show. In the, you know, in the talk show. Where is it? This one. Yeah, that was the scene they played. It was the same one, you know, the about the night she was about to die, she performed the rite. That was the scene. But there is something here. There was another vibration. Please be something new.
I found the 20th century overwhelming. I ended up in London, swept there by the culture. I modeled. I hadn't thought much about movies, but when they told me Fischer wanted to see me, I watched his. It was amazing to me, because his movies are similar to how we see the world, the compression of time. I felt Fischer was an artist, and I hoped to help. He wasn't kind when we met. He wasn't interested in teaching me. He wanted to sculpt me. Movies were like a sexual mania to him. He told me what to eat.
Told me what to eat. Like, she eats people. Oh, like, did he instruct her who to consume in order to change and become the person he wanted? Hold up. I'm starting to get an idea of what actually happened. Like, so the muse ate Marissa Marcel and became her. And while she was modeling, she was discovered by Fischer, and Fischer wanted to sculpt her, because we've heard this word before during the interview. He wanted to sculpt Marissa Marcel, it appears literally. So he instructed her on who to devour in order to change Marissa Marcel's personality so that she would become the actor he wanted. Is that what happened? Is that what the whole point is? And as she devoured more and more people, she accumulated more trauma, more of their fears and their horrors, as she said. So that's what destroyed her? Or maybe is that why she abandoned Arthur Fischer and went to John Durick? I don't know.
7 Bravo, take 2.
Action.
Oh, Lord. Thou will open my lips and my mouth shall declare thy praise. How many are my foes, Lord? How many rise against me? How many say of me there is no salvation for him in God, but you, Lord, are a shield around me, my glory. You keep my head high. With my own voice I will call out to the Lord, and he will answer me from his holy mountain.
Back to 2. Back to 1.
I lie down, and I fall asleep. I will wake up, for the Lord sustains me. Arise, Lord, save me, my God. For you strike the cheekbones of all my foes, you break the teeth of the wicked. May your blessings be upon your people.
All right, keep rolling. From the top, this time, Marissa, wait until he's looked away before you look up. I'll cue you. Action.
Oh, Lord, thou will open my lips and my mouth shall declare thy praise. How many are my foes, Lord? How many rise against me? How many say of me, there is no salvation for him in God, but you, Lord, are a shield around me, my glory. You keep my head high. With my own voice, I will call out to the Lord, and he will answer me from his holy mount.
I do too. Marissa.
I lie down, and I fall asleep. I will wake up, for the Lord sustains me. Arise, Lord. Save me, my God.
And back to 1.
For you strike the cheekbones of all my foes, you break the teeth of the wicked. May your blessings be upon your people.
Perfect. Moving on. Got?
I'm not entirely sure whose voice was directing. It didn't sound like Arthur Fischer. It was someone else. It's interesting how much the narrative changed by that tiny little detail as to where the camera was focused and who was looking at whom. I like that. It was really cool. There is something here. There it is. And it's gonna be we elevated humanity once again.
We tried to elevate humanity God by telling them later they made 2 Marys, but there was really only 1. I remember the time in the cave. I was dead, but that passed. The ascension was left to their imagination. I didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, she was in the cave. And is that why she woke up in the cave? She doesn't leave the cave? Not entirely sure. Also, the part about the 2 Marys got me thinking. Like, Marissa Marcel's name is Marissa. We've also heard Maria in the movie. And Matilda, that kind of sounds like Mary, but not as much as the other ones. And also that actor, during rehearsal, mistakenly called her Marina at some point. Anyway, I don't know.